got to be Chick-fil-A again. We got to go with the spicy chicken sandwich with Chick-fil-A sauce and a large fry. It's just, I go there so much that it's unhealthy, to be honest.
Are you doing that right after school? Or are you doing that for lunch, or when are you doing that?
We're doing that for lunch, and then maybe before a game, we might grab a banana and a yogurt or something like that to keep the energy going.
Favorite pregame meal or ritual?
I don't really eat before games, which is probably really bad, but I'll probably have like a PB&J or like an Uncrustable, and then a lot of water. But I mean, I don't like to eat before like games or practices because this is something I've never done. And okay, so I'll probably have to change that for college, but it's something I've never done. So
what's a favorite thing to do away from football right now?
Favorite thing to do away from football? I guess spending time with my friends in a very small group because we're quarantined. And then also playing video games is just really nice because I get to play with my friends there too.
Okay.
So just hanging with my brothers. I like scary movies, but like they're like really cheesy scary movies. Like my mom will like, let's watch like a cheesy scary movie. And I was like, sit down and watch like two or three of them during the night. And like, it'd be my whole night. And they'd be like, what are you doing? I'm like, I'm watching a movie with mom. Shut up. And so, I really like HBO, really like cheesy, scary movies. That's like, we're so predictable. Like it's crazy, but they're really funny to watch. So
something that people do not know about you.
Ooh, well, I used to be able to do the splits my freshman and sophomore year, but then I had hip surgery, so I wasn't I can't do it anymore. But
which way? Doing the splits front back or all the way to
front back. Front back.
That's killer.
That would be weird. Like that's something else like I never tried before. But yeah, so I would do the front to back splits for 2 years, and then after surgery I wasn't able to. But something I also, as I don't have two 14-year molars or something, like I'm missing two teeth. And so like my teeth don't line up like perfectly because I'll have two teeth on the bottom row, but not on the top. And so like I'll be chewing back there and I'll hit like my gum when I'm chewing. And so yeah, like hurts, but like, I'm like, what is going on? But then I remember I'm missing two teeth. So it's great.
Something people do not know about. I was going to say that I'm a twin, but people already know that about me because of the interview. But, something people don't know about me is that I dislike ice cream, hate ice cream.
Wait a minute. That's like un-American.
I know. I just don't like it for some reason. Not good.
Is it a texture thing or a flavor thing? What is it?
It's more of a flavor thing because I like sorbet some reason, but I just don't like ice cream.
Favorite walk-up song or kind of pregame hype song?
Gotta go Anybody by Young Thug featuring Nicki Minaj.
I mean, I don't think I have one, really. I like all kinds of music. Like, I don't like country a lot, but like I listen to it. But I mean, I don't really like listening to music before games. Like, I don't really need it to like lock me in because I've been around sports my entire life, so like I know what I need to do to be ready for games.
What's your favorite music?
Before games, probably rap, like not like hardcore, like I don't know, like not hardcore rap, but like rap that like has a good beat to it and stuff, like not fast, but like it's hard to explain, but like I like Post Malone, if he counts.
Okay.
I like Post Malone a lot, and so I listen to him before games. But like, I listen to anything.
Favorite all-time movie?
Oh man, I'd probably have to go Kicking and Screaming. It's an old Will Ferrell movie about soccer. But any Will Ferrell movie is really good. But Kicking and Screaming is probably my all-time favorite movie. I know all the lines to that movie, so my whole family does. So. I mean, it's one of my favorites.
I actually have a couple. The first one is Parasite, which came off of Hulu, I think, 2019.
Okay.
Such a good movie.
Is that like a horror thriller?
Yeah, it's a thriller. And then also Inception with Leonardo DiCaprio is one of my favorites.
Okay.
And Wolf of Wall Street with Leonardo DiCaprio is also one of my favorites.
So it sounds like Leonardo. So I'm waiting for you to tell me that now, like Titanic or something. It's one of your favorites.
No, that's a good movie, though. I like Titanic.
Favorite athlete of all time?
Ooh. Probably David Beckham, a soccer player. I grew up playing soccer until eighth grade. Eighth grade is when I started playing football. And so I was really big into soccer and like watching it. So probably David Beckham.
All right. Favorite wild animal?
Favorite wild animal? Got to be an owl.
An owl? Which an one? Owl. Is there a certain kind?
No certain kind. It's just owl was my first word, actually. So it's always just, I don't know.
Owl was your first word? So did you have like a stuffed owl toy?
I did, yeah.
Oh, pretty cool. Yeah. Now that's a picture I gotta get, like you and the owl.
There's probably a couple.
Oh, lion, hands down. I love lions. I used to like not care about animals and stuff, but then I watched this YouTube channel where the guy's lions and stuff, and like he lives in Africa, like with like wildlife and stuff, and he's like, lions are just beautiful. I love lions.
Here's one that you probably weren't prepared for. If you could meet anyone in history,
ooh,
and spend an hour with them, who would it be?
Got to go with some names coming up. Adolf Hitler.
Adolf Hitler?
Yeah.
Give me some background on that.
Some background. So if I were to meet anyone in history, I'd want to meet Adolf Hitler. Just because I feel like if I could understand why he was doing what he was doing, you know, it'd make a big difference. I don't know. I feel like it'd be really cool to – I guess not cool. It's kind of sad, but I guess it'd be cool to meet Adolf Hitler and then try to understand why.
There's so many. That's a tough one. There's a lot of good people. Probably Babe Ruth. Just because he really changed baseball and the way it was played. And like he's such an iconic figure that like it'd be great to just like sit down and like talk to him about like really anything. Singing down everything on the radio.